Addition is important, scaling is important, and the next question, of course, becomes how do you subtract two factors? We're going to see that that's just a matter of combining addition and scaling.
Let's recall the geometric interpretation of vector addition. You start with a vector x that you want to add to vector y. If you lay these head to toe, then the net result is the vector x plus y. If we duplicate y and x by moving them around, we can create a parallelogram. And sometimes this picture right here, where this diagonal of this parallelogram becomes x plus y, is known as the parallelogram method for vector addition. If instead we start with a vector x and we have a vector y, then taking the negative of that vector y means pointing it in the opposite direction. Now we have two vectors, x and minus y, that are head to toe. So x plus minus y is now the vector that's right there. There you have it. So x plus minus y is x minus y, and therefore this picture captures how to visualize the vector x minus y. Let's review the parallelogram method for vector addition. You lay out your vectors as such, and then the diagonal becomes x plus y. You can do the same thing for vector subtraction. You lay out your vectors, and then the other diagonal becomes the vector x minus y. Obviously, you have to make sure that it points in the right direction. Now, how do you compute x minus y? Well, you expose the different components of vectors x and y, and you simply subtract each component of y off the corresponding component of x. In summary, it's important to keep this picture in mind right here when you think of adding or subtracting two vectors. And subtracting one vector from another simply means subtracting the components of that vector from the corresponding components of the vector from which you're subtracting.